With floodwaters come all sorts of problems, including an abundance of new wildlife. Action 4's Brett Crandall reports on new residents many flooded homeowners have now inside their homes.
With so much water, animals and critters that live inside of the ground are coming out. As you can see here, we have millions of earthworms climbing up this tree trying to get out of the water.
Worms, frogs, snails, leeches, critters and bugs that normally live in the ground or canal are now on people's doorsteps. Worms on this flooded property are climbing trees, flower pots, and anything else they can find to get out of the water.
Those types of critters cannot breathe. They need oxygen. So if the water is so inundated into the ground, they're going to come up for air. So you'll see them crawling up along trees. You'll see them crawling up along plants.
Fortunately, Hidalgo County Health Director Eddie Olivares says none of these critters are dangerous. But mosquitoes are very much a concern. The county is already larvaciding by placing brick insecticides in standing water to kill mosquito larvae, which Olivares says is 70% more effective than fumigation.
The mosquitoes are going to start, and it's going to last for weeks, maybe months. It's not going to go away soon. We have way too much water, too many flooded areas.
Don't expect the worms, frogs, or snails to go away anytime soon until these waters recede. In Hidalgo County, Brett Crandall, Action 4 News.
Well, the health department cautions those affected by flooding to wear boots if they need to walk through that water to protect themselves from any type of infection. Here are some tips to do around your home to help reduce the number of potential breeding sites. Clean up around the house and yard. Get rid of any standing water. I know that's hard for those that have flooded lawns right now. Check your plant pot bases, throw them inside out, as well as palm fronds and roof gutters to make sure they're not blocked, that is, by leaf debris.